But I think what we need to do is we need to be clean and we need to be green and we need to be clever. Our clean green credentials are deep inside us, but they're also about where we need to be heading as a country. We can't be trading off our economy for our environment. And we can't sort of look after our environment and expect that always to be a cost on our economy. It's the wrong way of looking at it. We need to start rethinking about the way that we look at our growth forward and our environment. And that means doing it together. Our greatest advantage is our clean green image, both how we feel about our country, but also about how we make our money. The New Zealand economy and the way that we are perceived around the world, the thing that people know more than anything else is that we're clean and that we're green and we're 100% pure. Now, we're not exactly 100% pure. We all know that. I mean, we've got some work to do there. But that's the image. And it's the 22nd most recognised brand in the world. So it comes just after or just before Dell Computers, somewhere in that. I'm not sure if that's a good thing or a bad thing, but I mean, we're up there and people recognise it. But still, it's something that we should be proud of and something that we should build on. And that means more work on our innovative companies, our high-tech companies, our high-value clean industries that can drive us forward. It's not about agriculture versus manufacturing or whatever. It's both. It's an and, it's not an or. And we need to do both together. The second thing and the last thing I wanted to mention was that growing the economy, which is the very issue that we've been pushing for more than anything else in this budget and over the past few weeks. Growing the economy is for everybody. And that's the issue that the National Party doesn't get. It's not growing the economy and keeping wages at $13.61 an hour. It's actually growing the economy so that everybody benefits. It's about fairness. It's about reducing that gap between rich and poor that is growing so wider and wider and wider. We have to address that. This is one of the most corrosive things that could happen to New Zealand. So it is about, and I come back to that same theme that I started with, it is about opportunity. And opportunity in education is number one, because that is the place where we need to start from. And when you have 87,000 people, young people, not employed and not in education, you're not doing something right in your education system that enables that to happen. Because that's not just about a waste of talent. It's actually about a ticking time bomb that goes on and on and on. So that's something that we really need to get on top of that we're not doing sufficiently right now. And that starts right back at early education. Childhood, first 3-4 years of life. And all of the statistics, and I think Jacinda Ardern was here yesterday, and she may have spoken about this, but it's something that we know for sure. And we know actually not only for sure, but economically for sure, that if you spend a dollar then, and this has been worked out by a Nobel laureate, you save $11 at age 18. So that's what we need to do now, and that's what we need to be preparing for. Now, I could go on and on about education, because that's something that's very passionate. I'm a former teacher, so my father was a teacher, so it kind of runs in my bloodline. But this is something that I do believe we need to really look at in a way that we're not seeing at the moment, where we just somehow increase class sizes, and some of that money we save goes back into making better teachers. Some of it, we don't know where the other part of the money goes. So with that, I'm going to leave you with education and opportunity and fairness, which I believe are the underlying principles and values of our party, and ask for questions and comments. Thank you very much.